everybody. Thank you for joining us on another day with the excursion couples. And we are on day 4 and 5 as we explore our second day in Sinaia and our first day in Busteni.
Good morning, everybody. Me and Cindy just woke up. And right now we're grabbing some brunch.
We're at a traditional slash Italian restaurant called Restaurant Wood. It's pretty close to our hotel, a couple of steps away from us. We're gonna try this out. Italian and traditional Romanian. I got the mamaliga. Brie got the carbonara pasta. And we got some wings and some other stuff. So we'll see how it tastes. Brie accidentally ordered Bailey's liquor coffee instead of like a regular coffee.
So I got my Bailey's espresso coffee with whipped cream. I'm gonna go ahead and try it out. I love drinking my coffee in the morning. It has a liquor taste to it. So I think I accidentally ordered liquor coffee, which I'm supposed to order, and espresso. So it's gonna be a wild morning, I guess, for me. Tastes kind of like chicken stock. It's a very fresh soup. I think these are the same as the the one that's like
polenta.
Uh-huh.
Corn.
Mm-hmm. That's a spongy taste to it. But it's not like bad. It's actually very decent. Go ahead and try it out.
Is it cheesy?
It's good. Mm-hmm. It's very fresh. The pastas are homemade. They're like soft noodles. Yeah, it's good.
I got the mamaliga. Got some fried eggs on top. Polenta. Some sausages. Chicken. And it's kind of like feels like a curry dish in a way. I'm gonna try out the chicken. Chicken's very tender.
Okay.
It kind of just falls off, kind of like a Wagyu beef in a way. You can try the sausage.
Okay.
The sausage is also very, very soft.
Mm-hmm.
Seasoned really nicely. It's not overly salted, it's like perfectly salted.
Mm-hmm.
The polenta. Nice and soft. Kind of has like a soupy taste.
And the fried egg is good.
Just had our brunch and we're heading to the monastery now. But first, we are going to take some drone shots. We're gonna go take some drone shots. And as you can see, it is very beautiful. The mountain view and the homes and the hotels, restaurants, all on hills. Great place to be if you want to get away from the city. It's a nice little vacation spot for the locals or the Romanians that live in Bucharest and some other cities that are bigger. It's a great place to come. And for tourists, so not too far away from Bucharest, an hour and 30 minutes on train.
After our brunch, we just walked around Dimitrie Ghica Park and explored the place, and we saw that there was a casino there. It looked like it's from the early 1900s, and we saw a stray dog who was very cute. And after that, we went up the hill to Sinaia's Monastery, and the monastery was from the 15th century. It was really old, but very historical and beautiful. I will say that it's a great place to visit if you are in town. It's a cool reminder of what the monasteries looked like back in the days, and also a great view from up top from where the monastery is. Later on in the evening, we went to a restaurant called Bistro 27 back in the center of town, and they make traditional Romanian food and Italian food. I would highly recommend it. You guys should try it if you're ever in town.
I ordered a pork meatball soup. It has a potato base to it. The potato, onion, more sour. Sour and savory. I'm gonna try a meatball. So this is a meatball. It's pork. The meat is very, very soft. The seasoning is really good. It's a sour taste to it. I like it. It also has a little bit of rice in there too. I taste a bell pepper too.
Or the meat.
So these are the mici. It's supposed to be really soft sausage. I'm gonna go ahead and try it out. Oh, the way they cook their things are really good. Try mici at a different restaurant. It wasn't as good as this one. This one's really good.
This time, Bree's gonna try it in the dip. I think it's honey mustard, I'm guessing.
I'm guessing too. Yeah. It's actually mustard. It looks like they just took it out from the oven and yeah. So you can see it's still sizzling. Yeah. And let me go ahead and the manager told me that this is a good one, so look at the cheese. It just melts. Wow. Butter, garlic. The salt is perfect. The cheese melts right in. The pasta is so soft. Oh my god, this is something that there's mushrooms too, so the mushrooms, oh look at how the cheese just melts. Oh my god, it's like a strain of cheese. Now I have to.
Oh yeah.
And this is the chicken breast. Look at the cheese.
Something about in Romania, when they make pork dishes, it's really good. Especially this one. The sauce or the seasoning on it, it's kind of like feels like an Indian taste to it. Kind of curry-ish feel. A little tomato and then some seasoning, kind of garlicky. It's really good. The fat that's layered on top of that pork, it kind of almost melts in your mouth. That's a smoked sausage right there. It's really good. Not too hard, or not too harsh. Perfect. Try the polenta. Oh. Yeah, this is a good polenta. This thing literally just melts in your mouth right when you just chew on it. It's gone. Just like that. Try the eggs with it. Get the eggs on it. Eggs, polenta. Ooh, it's gonna be hard, but eggs and polenta. Good combination. Corn and eggs. If we were eating brunch right now, I would love this. This is the perfect brunch. Especially like after a hangover or something. This is the perfect brunch right here.
The fat is still on it. It's so chewy. Oh yeah.
After our meal, we went to go try something called the Kurtos, which is kind of like a cinnamon bun that's been rolled around a one rod.
Okay, here. Let me try it.
It's so big.
Yeah. Mmm. Wow.
What is it?
It's sweet, of course. It has a bread taste to it. Mmm. Not super sweet where it's like, we can't take it. It's a perfect type of sweet. It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's really good. Mmm. Yeah, this is really good.
Thing is huge. It's like Thanos' mm-hmm. gauntlet right here.
I mean, I don't know about that, but it's huge. Mmm. And I can put my whole hand in there. We're gonna be heading out to the next city. I believe it's called Busteni. We're gonna grab breakfast first. Probably gonna go to an Indian place again. Me and Singhi just left our hotel and we're grabbing some breakfast. See what we're grabbing for breakfast in a bit.
It's a light meal before we head out to Busteni, which is only 10 minutes train ride from here. I think we order some eggs Benedict for Brie, and I got the ham and eggs combo, which comes with water and an espresso for like only 20 lays, which is only like $4 or $5. So not too bad. Good place to eat here. I would highly recommend coming here if you are hungry.
It's really good. It doesn't have that greasy breakfast to it. It's a very light. The avocado, the bread, there's no grease to it. It's just really, really light. It has a really light taste to it. Mm. All the flavor is there. Dip this in there. Try it with the sauce here. I don't know what this sauce is, but I'm gonna have to try it out. Let's try it. Tomato sauce, not ketchup, more of a real tomato sauce.
I got a simple ham and cheese, or not ham and cheese, ham and eggs with some toast on the side. And I got some hot sauce with some veggies on the side. So, see how it tastes. The tomato sauce is kind of like a marinara sauce. It goes pretty well with the eggs, ham, and the toast, buttered up. Really good.
After a really good brunch, we caught the train to Busteni, and it was a couple minutes away. When we got off, we walked a couple of minutes more and got to our hotel called Caius Hotel and checked in.
Hey guys, welcome to our hotel that we're staying at for 2 days in Busteni. Just show you around. It's really small. It's kind of like a studio, but a little smaller. Come on in. So you got the bed, which is probably a queen size. Looks pretty nice, right? The colors, gray and blue, white, nice matching color. And then we have the TV, pretty decent size. Looks like a 40 inch to 50 inch. The coolest thing is the patio. You gotta check out the view, it's awesome. Right now it's raining, so if you check it out, if you look at the view, you can't see it right now, but the mountain is literally right there. So we got the mountain view for the next 2 days. It took a 8-minute walk from the train station to get here. It was a little hard to get up here from down at the train station because you had to come up a little bit, and it's pretty steep for like 2-3 minutes. But other than that, it was pretty easy, fairly easy to get to. This is where our robe and slippers are. I guess if you want to go to the jacuzzi that they have, we'll probably show you it later. We just put a jacket here, but extra pillows and blankets are here. Pretty nice. I mean, I would say I love these type of blankets. They're like the fox fur ones. It's really soft, so it's pretty small, but it's pretty interesting at the same time. I don't know, but it looks like a lot of the hotels have those types of toilets. It's kind of like a square, like rectangle, like square shape, rectangular shape toilets. And then this is a pretty cool, I've never seen a door like this where it's inverted. So in order to close the door, you gotta pull it out like this. Doesn't close all the way, it's a little gap, but it's one of those the rain showers, the rain shower heads. Sink is pretty simple. I don't know what this does. Let's check. Oh, it lights up. It's one of those makeup type mirrors. So the one that lights up. Perfect Brie, yep.
After we were checked into the hotel, in the evening we went to Prince George Grigor Contesino's castle. Contesino's castle was built in 1911 and nowadays it is served as a museum. At the time there was a Japanese exhibition going on. Prince Contesino was named Prime Minister of Romania between 1899 to 1900 and during 1904 to 1907. He was born from the old noble Contesino family, being a descendant of Romanian rulers of Contesino, emperors of the Byzantine Empire. So after taking a tour around the castle, we walked about 15 minutes to find some food and we stopped by a place called La Etage in the town of Busteni.
I ordered beef soup. So I've never tried it before, but it looks like it has carrots, potato, beans, and this is the potato, beans, and carrots, and probably
looks good.
A little bit of onion in there too. I usually always try my broth. It's pretty good. I'm gonna dip my bread right in there. It's really good. We got shrimp butter. We got parmesan rice, we got chicken wings with the sweet and sour,
some potato.
It's chewy, it's good. I'm gonna try my shrimp first. It's good. Tastes a little wine in there. This is the parmesan and wild rice. Nutty.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
I never have rice like this. It's pretty good. Of course, my mashed potato.
How about the
typical mashed potato?
Yeah.
And chicken wing. Okay.
I can hear that. Crispy. Juicy.
It's a very homemade taste to it. I like it. Typical, fried chicken you'll make, but I'm gonna go ahead and dip it into the sweet sour sauce. Okay, I'm gonna try this. How sweet sour is that? Asian egg roll sauce. So yeah, I'm used to these. I know what this is. So
I got the mama liga. Trying to cut up the sausage.
Got it. Try this out. Super juicy on the inside. Outside is really crispy. The inside's pretty tender. Seasoning is perfect. It's not over salty or it's not under. It's perfect. Try polenta with it. I think this is like my third or fourth mama liga dish, so. It's gonna be one of my favorite comfort foods. This is a little dry. It's smoked nicely. Feels like a barbecue.
So we hope you enjoyed day 4 and 5 of Romania and we hope to see you soon. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. See you tomorrow.